Okay, Brother Wayne is gonna come, and he has a miracle testimonial too in a lot of different areas, but the area of healing, he almost lost a kidney, but he stood up in faith and he still got his too.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
That's right.
But we have to remember that when we were born in this world, we were born in sin.
Yes.
this body, according to the scripture, is dead to sin, and the life of Christ might live through us, because we, our bodies, are subject to sickness. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. But yet sickness don't have to remain in our body.
Amen.
Through the life of Christ, through the life and the blood of Jesus Christ,
amen,
and through his word, praise God, sickness has to go if you believe God's word.
Amen.
So I would encourage you to pick up those confessions,
yes,
that our pastors laid before us,
yes,
and begin to use that word.
Yes.
I mean, it's a sword in your hand if you use it.
Yes.
I mean, you will see God manifest himself on your behalf through his word, because
yes,
his word will never fail.
Amen.
Hallelujah. But if you're willing to put your trust and confidence in it and see, hallelujah, it being manifested, what's been written in scripture. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father.
Yes.
I better get on to Judges. That's why I think I better spin a pier behind it. Put a pier just in case this happens. I can hide it. Hallelujah. And Judges 6. Thank you, Father. And number one said, I'm not going to read all of this. I might jump around a little bit. So kind of hang with me. And the children of Israel did even in the sight of the Lord, and the Lord delivered them in the hand of the Midian 7 years. So you see it spelled out where the children of Israel did evil in the sight. And one of the things they did, they fell seated out of the God, putting other idols before him. And then verse 2, then the hand of Midianite prevailed against Israel, and because of the Midianite, the children of Israel made them dens, which are in the mountains, and caves, and strongholds. And they put a whooping on the children of Israel so bad that they want to hide. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God's people wanted to hide. Thank you, Father. Verse 3, and so it was when the Israel had sown that the Midianite came up, and the Amalekites and the children of the east, even they came up against them, and they encamped against them, and destroyed the increase of the earth till they come unto Gaza, and left no substance for Israel, neither sheep nor ox nor iron. For they came up with their cattle and their tents, and they came as grasshoppers and multitude. For both they and their camels were without number, and they entered into the land and destroyed it. Verse 6, and Israel were greatly impoverished because of the Midianites, and the children of Israel cried unto the Lord. Say with me, cry unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. There's two types of cries that I'm gonna make mention of them. I mean, I don't know if I have a title per se. If you want to put a title on it, you can say cry and cry. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Because someone mentioned it, I think my wife mentioned it on a Wednesday. Thank God for her. Very precious woman indeed. I thank God for how God is using her and the ministry that she has. Truly has been a blessing to me since she joined me almost about 1 year ago. What do you mean joined me about 1 year ago? Well, she worked most of the different shifts for about almost work every some year. I did it, so 1 year ago, almost about this time, she decided to quit work. And then she home with Brother Wayne. Hallelujah. And it's been kind of nice. I used to have PJ sitting there watching me. Me and him looking at each other trying to, you know, oh Lord Jesus. He you look at that means wonder what you want to say. And he got well, just staring you down. You sit there looking at me, he don't blink. He just stares you, like he's trying to read your mind. Interesting little dog, but nevertheless. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Father. But the children of Israel became impoverished. Can you imagine the children of Israel, the children of God, being impoverished, wanting to hide because of what they're going through, because of the challenge they were facing? Let me tell you something, when you go through certain things in life, if it has a tendency to put pressure on you, that you want to withdraw yourself from everybody, hallelujah, glory to God. But it's not God's will and purpose for you that you draw back or that you hide from the challenge that you're facing. Thank you, Lord. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. And then we see in verse 6, the children of Israel cried unto the Lord. And verse 7, it came to pass when the children of Israel cried unto the Lord because of the Midianites, the Lord sent a prophet unto the children of Israel, which said to them, thus saith the Lord of God of Israel, I brought you up from Egypt and brought you forth out of the house of bondage. And I delivered you out of the hand of Egyptians, and out of the hand of all that oppressed you, and drave them out from before you, and gave you their land. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Do anybody cry very much these days? Hallelujah. And I admit that someone said, I think it was my Bible, it might be my wife, where she said, it's best to cry now, hallelujah, instead of having a pressure of life up against you, cry out to the Lord before you get into trouble. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But I can tell you, I have cried a lot. Boy, I tell you, when the affliction that came up against my body, and when, you know, I thank God for doctors. I do appreciate them. Sometimes you might hear me sound like I bash them a little bit. But you know, I truly thank God for them. I mean, they have a craft or in school and the knowledge.
That's right.
It ain't always right, but nevertheless, hallelujah, you still have to trust the Lord.
That's right.
Even if you go to them, you better trust the Lord even more.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Because there was one woman that went to the doctors in the Bible that had the issue of blood. The Bible said the woman spent all of her money trying to get healing and wholeness to her physical body. Thank you, Lord. And then wind up, instead of getting better, the scripture says she got worse. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Until she met the Master. Hallelujah. She said within herself, I can just touch the hem of his garment.
Yes.
See, if you can get in a position to touch him, no matter what you're going through, no matter what's going on in your body, you can position yourself to touch him with your faith and believe what his word says,
yes.
Your situation can change.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Amen.
And I cried out to the Lord. And I said, Lord, help me. And I'm kind of getting ahead of myself, but let me go ahead and finish reading this. Because you heard the children of Israel, since they got whooped real bad, they beat up by the enemy, torn pretty much asunder because of their sins. That the Bible said, because the sins before the Lord turned them over to the Midianites. Hallelujah. Because one thing about it, once he spoke to you, spoke to you something not to do, then you go and do it. You just open yourself up to the other side of God. Hallelujah. His word never changed. Well, he's spoken out of what's going to happen. You shall reap what you sow, you're going to reap it. And through his grace and his mercy now, when you cry out to him and want to turn from your wicked ways and seek him, he will heal your body. He will heal your children. He will heal your home. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. But you must turn from him and cry out to him. Because he loves us. He's our children. Hallelujah. He becomes our help in a time of need. Thank you, Father. We're blessed. Hallelujah. Don't go to sleep on me now. I'm keep my eyes there looking at you. Because I appreciate, you know, that even last Sunday, to get your preach on. Because that was one evening that I was tired. I said, I want a ready one, just relax and, you know. And I said, well, I'm going to church. I told him why we're going, but I'm looking for somebody to do some preaching.
Amen.
And they did, boy, they preached.
That's right.
God got some people in here that he wants to use.
Yes.
And you wondering what, you know, why the enemy is fighting you so hard. To get you, to deter you from what God has set before you.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
And stop making up excuses. And just like Gideon did, he made up a lot of excuses.
Yes.
Same thing Moses. Moses said, but I can't speak too good. I mean, God, he ain't gonna let you get away with no excuse.
You
can throw up, he let you say what all you wanna say, but he's still gonna say, I wanna use you. Well, you gonna go to all right. Keep on going through this life. Because I can tell you, I was one of them to make us you. You never know what that dude called me for. You never know what that. He talks a lot better. His English is a little bit better than mine. You know, Lord, you never know them. Because the older I get, to see like my dialect term begin to be more like my southern, where I came from. It just begin to change. Even now, my family, sometimes I talk to them, they just look at me. And I have to kind of slow it down a little bit so they can get understanding what I'm saying. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. I'm talking verse 10. And I said unto you, I am the Lord God, and fear not for the God of the Amorites, in whom the land you dwell, but you have not obeyed my voice. The Lord is speaking to some of you. He is speaking, he is waiting patiently on you. I mean, he has time. Time is on his side. But your time is short.
Yes.
And it is getting shorter because what God is calling for in this time and daytime, he's calling for you because the work that he want to do is a quick work.
Yes.
That's why you say you wonder where you're going to school. See, you wonder why you're in class being trained right now. Why you're in prayer school? Why you in Sunday school? Why you in Wednesday night Bible study school? Because you are being prepared for the master use.
Yes.
I mean, you're not getting into all this world to sit back and just to know, oh, well, I got this. Use it for my own, my house, no more. But now God have a purpose and a plan.
Yes.
For your life to use you, to speak in someone's life, to minister someone's life, to save someone, to bring deliverance to someone through the word of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And some of us want to back up and shy away. But if God speaks to you, he wants to speak to you and say, be strong in the Lord.
Yeah.
In the power of might. Now, yeah, I mean, I tell you now, I stand up here, I get a little nervous still. And let me tell you something, you better be nervous when you stand before God. People want to speak on God's behalf. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
Because you know you gotta understand who you represent.
That's right.
It's all right, shape, whatever is going on. But do what he tells you to do.
Yes.
Obey him. Because when you stand before, hallelujah, God being used by God, he will give you what to say in the time.
Yes.
Hallelujah. All the nervousness and the fear of what people see, all the eyes, and look at me now. He'll allow you to look past that.
Yes.
He begins in the seed of soul, and they begin to draw from you, from what God has in you, to feed them.
Yes. That's right.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Church is a place of feeding. But not to be fed to the point that you come overfed and not give out. Thank you, Lord. And verse 11, and there came an angel of the Lord and sat under the oak which was Ophrah, and pertaining to Joash and Azariah, and his son Gideon threshed wheat by the winepress, and hid it from the Midianite.
Yes.
See, Gideon was out working, staying busy. But God sees his faithfulness.
Yeah.
God sees your faithfulness.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
And verse 12, and the angel of the Lord appeared unto him and said unto him, Lord, the Lord is with thee, thou mighty man of valor. God speaks to his into his life,
yes,
to give him confidence, to say, you can do it. Whatever I call you for, I have equipped you. The calling of God and the gift of God is without repentance.
Yes, yes.
And I would wonder, you know, in our company, we set goals every year. And even this year, they reminded us what our goal was last year, and they said, well, we want more. And I thought, I wonder if God like that. Do he want more from us? Or he settled just for what we have. We got the Holy Spirit, and he gave some of us a talent or two, and we just live within that arena and then wait till Christ come or we go off the scene. That's it. And I think not. The investment that he made in you, praise God, he wants a return on that.
That's it.
He is expecting you to increase more. Remember the one that a talent? That he is one of the talents that called he built God and wanted when it buried. The Lord would bury in with him. Hallelujah. So he is expecting a return from you, the gift that he has placed within you. He wanted to increase it even the more. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Because I never would have thought that one day that I was standing before people. That never hit my mind. My shit showed up in Northside, but never would have thought that. Nobody ever could have told me that would have. Huh. Hallelujah. If through the faith of our pastors and the training that I had here at Northside, hallelujah, they seeing the gift of God in me. And I remember about, I think like 2 years after I showed here, they had me teaching first class. Woo! And I remember wondering, like, people would even me? Oh, God, oh, country boy, because I'm, you know, I'm just comfortable. I mean, I can get up here in coveralls and just talk to you. I don't have no sit on the suit. Hallelujah. And choose somebody like me to put his word into, to speak to his people.
Hallelujah.
Let me tell you, some of you, God is calling you.
Yes,
Lord. He wants to remind you, he is calling you out for use for his purpose. It's not necessary to stand up here, but to minister to other people.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You might be an usher today. I remember I ushered. Enjoy ushering. They stopped letting me usher for some reason. Hallelujah. I mean, you can sit back there, you have freedom, you can dance, you know. You know, no have to worry about anybody looking at you. Hallelujah. But I'll tell you, what God is calling, you will hear me say this many times over, God is calling for some of you. And I would encourage you to find your place, talk to your pastors here, and get counsel, let them help and direct you in the pathway you go so you can feel God's calling on you. Because we come into a close of our life that we have in here, is a cycle as we know it as now. That God is going to use people to speak in people's lives even more. And he wants you to be ready because this is what you've been doing. You've been coming here Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. And some people come almost seem like almost 7 days a week here. You've been training. You're in the school. There's a Northside Christian in the school to be trained, to be equipped, to be successful in ministry for the Christ, for the call of Christ on your life. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And the one that he called, he has given the ability to do what he called you to do. Thank you, Father. Just like he called Gideon. Praise you, Father. And verse 18, and Gideon said unto him, O my Lord, if the Lord be with us, why then did all these befall us? And that's where I know I have said that in my own life. Lord, if you be with me, why am I going through this? Why I'm going through these doctors and listening to them tell me this and what's going on, you need to do this. We need to remove your 20 kidneys. You really need to take care, you need to prepare yourself so we can do this work on you and your body and all the different things that are going through to change my body. Talking about staying up day, 3 days of a row with no sleep. Couldn't sleep because I desired to sleep because of the pain that was going through my head was so tremendous. I thought I'd do it just sit up in the chair. And you know, I am sure pressed on the chair sometimes. Let me tell you, keep on pressing if you can. Because if you can get here in the presence of God, it would encourage your heart even more. Hallelujah. Because the anointing of God will break the yoke. Thank you, Father. And I have noticed a different time when I pressed on anyway. When I left out of here, the pressure have leave and left my body. Thank you, Father. My days where I couldn't even eat. Couldn't even hardly even drink water. Even when I drank water, it would make me sick. Hallelujah. But if you cry out now, yes. Hallelujah. I may have cried out then, but I'm learning now before anything else comes, I'm going to cry out to the Lord now. Yes. Hallelujah. And even in the midst of my crying, when I cried out to him, he heard me. Hallelujah. Yes. And he delivered me.
Yes.
Thank you, Father.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Yes. He ain't going to leave you in the same state that you're in. Hallelujah. There's, like I said, two different cries that the Gideon had. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord Jesus, time is getting away. Thank you, Father. But if you cry now, like we did on yesterday morning, what a good prayer.
Amen.
Woo, saints. I'll tell you, I don't know what. If you don't understand what you're missing, you're missing something that's going to get you over in life. I mean, the prayer of the righteous avail much. That means if you are the righteous God in Christ Jesus, your prayer prevail. Well, I teach that from next time. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. And Gideon said, where of all the miracles which our father told us, saying, hallelujah. And like I said that and through what I was going to. All the years, Father, I read your word and hear words preached about how you were able to heal. Hallelujah. And Lord, here I am, I going through what I'm going through. Where is your miracle power now? Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 And so you pick up your confession seat. And I've done it. I confess one thing or another. Confess one, try to find God in the middle of my confession of my scriptures. And I didn't find him in there. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But I'm going to tell you, there's a place you can find him. Hallelujah. When you cry out to him in the name of Jesus. There's a place in worship you can find his presence. If you can get in worship to God and lift your hand and magnify him, hallelujah, he will show up. Glory to God. In the middle of your circumstances. Bring life and healing to your body, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. He's not willing to none should perish, but all should come to repentance. What Jesus went through is a real work. What he's suffering in his body on our behalf. Hallelujah. For us, for you. Praise God. And he said, all we have to do is receive. If you believe, receive. We are a believer, so we receive. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Where is the miracles that we spoke about? Where is, hallelujah, deliverance that you promised? Thank you, Lord. And I'm going to believe that some of you have been quiet also. Just like Gideon did. Just like I did. Just like David did. Hallelujah. But one thing, his arm is not short that he cannot save. Nor his ears heavy that he cannot hear. But his ears are open to the cry of the righteous. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You mean to tell me David had a testimony in Psalm 103. He healed all my diseases. Hallelujah. He forgave all my iniquity. I said, where he got that from? Hallelujah. To have that testimony, he must have experienced it. See, he didn't have what we had today, the word that we had. Glory to God. Because Jesus had not that pain yet. Thank you, Father. He had only just the Old Testament promises to rely on. Thank you, Father. But we have a surety. We have promises, better promises. That God, through his Son, Jesus Christ, shed his blood. Hallelujah. In regard to what he said and in the word of God, he was able to form it. If we're able to hallelujah, produce faith to believe in what he has said. All through the gospel, all I saw in there was, do you believe that I'm able to do this?
Yes.
According to your faith be it unto you. Hallelujah. It is my will for you to be healed. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You mean to tell me this woman went and sought out Jesus for her daughter? Thank you. Canaanite woman, I believe it was. She went to deliver for her daughter, and she came unto Jesus for deliverance. And Jesus told her, this is not for you. This is for the children of Israel. It's not for me to give the children's food unto the daughter. See, we see that, and first thing we think in our mind, it seems like, you know, it's an insult. Don't you know that Jesus already knew what this woman was going to say?
Yes.
But he wanted to get her around to faith and persistence.
Yes.
See, we would now, and whatever we believe in God for to do in our lives, we would have persistence.
There you go. Yes.
And also mix it with faith, believing that he will do what he said. But when the Son of Man comes, will he find faith in the earth? There's one thing to make a confession, but another thing to believe in what you're saying. Yes. He's willing to do what he said he's going to do. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah now.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to come through this because time is running out. Thank you, Lord. If any of you have read that story of Gideon, even though that verse, hallelujah, I believe in 7, chapter 7, he basically gave Gideon the victory. He started out with thousands of armed men. And God told him, no, you have too many people. You don't need that many people that what I'm going to do. Because if I give you all these people go into battle, the first thing the children of Israel will start beginning to say is, we did this. Hallelujah. And I'm going to say it like this. You can take it how you want to take it. I just feel like saying it because that's what the Spirit is saying. And I can say nothing wrong going to doctors. That's all right. Go to them. Praise God. Hallelujah. But don't give them too much credit.
That's right.
Be careful giving them too much credit.
Right.
Hallelujah. Always admonish God in whatever you're doing and whatever's going on in your life. And give God the all to pray.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Because there are too many people that went under this law, but they didn't come out.
Yes.
So you still had to trust the Lord. No matter.
That's right.
No matter.
That's right.
Compared to they had this something in here, there, and there, there is what I tell them, another one I want to get. Counsel for another one. The one would tell me, well, you do whatever he told you to do. I said, well, okay. Go over here to somebody else and get them. Review with them. So listen and tell me, same thing. Well, whatever he told you to do, you do what he said. So I finally found somebody. Hallelujah. Glory to God. He said, I don't believe what you're going through. You're actually counseling your body. I said, okay, that sounds good. Hallelujah. But, you know, it costs quite a bit of money.
Yeah.
Some people say, man, but, you know, hey, man, you got, you know, you come to your money, don't mean nothing.
Yeah.
Well, I pondered that a little bit myself. You know, the money they want to charge me, you know. Lies the Lord, hey, you hear what they say. I done had enough of being traveling here. They did x-rays, probe and prop, and did all kind of stuff, all kind of CT scans. This one here, the next one, the deeper than the next one. That wasn't good enough, we need to do another one. Every doctor want to do whatever they want to do. And they basically come to using me as a cash cow. And I said, enough is enough. I've been looking at this word about what you have done for me for 30 years. Saying that you be healed.
Yes, Lord.
It's time to put that trust in this. Lord, no more. I said, Lord, you want me to do this promise? I promise you, if you heal me, I will tell people. That's the covenant I made with him. And I tell people, at my job, I don't care where I'm at, I talk to one guy in the voting line. You give me enough time, I'm going to tell you what God has done. And I'm going to keep on telling you because it's reaffirm. It is still the issue in my mind. I haven't got no confirmation from a doctor of what that took place. I just believe his word. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And God is calling more of you. Don't make them excuses. Gideon tried to make up excuses. He said, I am the least of my clan. Then he gets to return to read that part. You can go back and read it when you get home. I'm the least of my household. Why do you want to use me? Hallelujah. Lord, I'm from the Red Hill of Mary Elizabeth that nobody knows about. When you Google it, you won't see them a tree. Why do you want to use me? Someone in here can speak more eloquent than I do. I want you. That's what he told Gideon, I want to use you. And he said, go in this way. What I have spoken to you, I will be with you. Hallelujah. See, one thing, the saints of God, we have to know to have the confidence that when you show up for him, he'll show up with you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Father. He has not left us alone. He'll never leave us. He'll always be with us. And you that go on and face and do whatever you might be facing, he's with you. Like I started talking about what Gideon said, where is it? All those miracles. You should hear some of them today.
Amen.
I can point out 4, 5, 6 of them right here now.
Yes.
And the rest of you, you are a miracle, but you saved by grace.
Amen.
Not by works that any man should boast. Hallelujah. Amen. And you have a testimony that God wants to use, hallelujah, to bring someone in for to be saved.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
We have many words of God. The righteousness are bold as a lion. In this day and time, it's time for us to be bold for the Lord. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Glory to God. Because we just read the scripture in Revelation, I believe it was, for the 8 and 20, I believe it was. I mean, Revelation 20 and 1. And that first thing you mentioned about the fearful. You don't want to be one that are fearful. When God calls you, Lord, I'll be making excuses. Hallelujah. For thou his righteousness and his peace. Because we have the boldness in us, the boldness of the one in us. And one of the scriptures I'm going to leave with you now, I'm going to sit down. Romans 8. Oh, bless his name. I've been just reading the scripture over and over and over again. And I heard one minister on that blessed me well. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Romans 8 and 10. It says, and if Christ be in you, the body is dead because of sin. But the Spirit is life because of righteousness.
Yes, yes.
And verse 11, but if the Spirit of him, hallelujah, that raised up Jesus from the dead, dwell in you.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
He that raised up Christ from the dead should also quicken your mortal body by the Spirit that dwelleth in you.
Yes.
That scripture right there should do something to you.
There you go.
I mean, if that scripture don't move you,
yes.
I better come check your pulse. I know everybody have their favorite scripture, so called. But this scripture here is speaking directly to the believer in this day and time. It is telling you, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, all three of them is living in you.
Yes. Hallelujah. Yes.
That same power that raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you.
Yes.
And tell me one reason. How can sickness stay in your body if it's dwelling in you?
That's right. That's right.
God the body, the same power that raised him from the dead. Like I said, the labor scripture said, which one is easier? Thou sin to give it or take up your bed and walk? Which one of all, to raise Jesus from the dead or heal your body? Hallelujah. Glory to your name, Jesus. Oh, I believe it with every fiber of my being. I mean, if I have one scripture I will play over and over again, that's basically what I've been doing. I had this one CD, this one ministry I've been playing over and over again.
I don't even go back and go to the other CDs. I just did one CD over and over again. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Because you see it in it, not only one, but you see it twice. And it said, he that dwell, he. You talk about the Holy Spirit. Do he dwell in you? Hallelujah. He that raised up Jesus, raised up Christ from the dead, should also quicken your mortal body by his Spirit that dwelleth in you. I mean, you can get that settled completely. I mean, if like I said, the Gideon story, throw it out. Throw it out. This one here, pick up and take it home with you. And begin to pray and meditate. Lord, what are you saying in this here? For me. Because what Christ has done for us, the work that he has done for us, is a reality. And it's real. But the devil, like we said, because of sin, the old man, the heart of the sin, we were born into sin. He can have access, attack our body. But every man is born in sin. Hallelujah. But sickness and sin don't have to stay in your body because of another law. There's a new sheriff in town. But the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We're not under the old law. Hallelujah. But we are embracing truth in Christ Jesus. Yes. Amen? Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. But that scripture there, take it home with you.
Yes.
Sleep on it.
Yes.
Say it over and over again.
Yes.
Say it 1,000 times. Mix it with faith.
Yes.
Believe that it is so.
Yes.
And begin to talk like getting your talk.
Yes.
Lord, you say. This is not Brother Wayne promising. We talking about what God had promised. But this is the same talk that I had to say too, because I said, Lord, you say in your word that I've been healed. According to Isaiah 53, Matthew 8:17, 1 Peter 2:24. And all I see through scripture, which we have already done, what you said, it is my will. Hallelujah. And Lord, I receive. Not only just, physical, emotionally, financial. The same thing that I'm in being broke.
That's right.
Not enough to meet your need.
That's it.
It's the same word. He became poor that we might have been rich.
That's right.
He emptied himself. He gave up something for us. It's the same word. That means he will make a way. Somehow the way, it means he fed whoever it was, Isaiah, a prophet Isaiah, with the ravens to take care of him. You mean you being his child? Matter of fact, it said you being evil knows how to give good gifts to your children. How much more? Your heavenly Father knows what you have need of. Well, praise God, I'm way over my time. And I appreciate y'all taking the time to listen to me. I thank God for every one of you. I thank God for your praying and your prayers. What God is doing here, saints, we have a right to rejoice. I remember when I first came here, boy, they be some jumping people. All the folks, they jumped and shouted.
Yes.
We got there right now, even now to shout. Yes. There's a shout that God is waiting for.
Yes, hallelujah.
We are holding it. I don't know who we're holding it for. Yes. He's been so good to us. You see me, I do my little dance. I mean, I never was a good dancer, at all in the world. But I put my little foot up and down because I know God has been good to me.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes. Hit the phone later to try to float down with me. It's stepped all over the foot. hug the wall more. But anyway, if you want me to pray with you, I mean, I ain't scared to pray with you. Did you know that he is the healer?
Yes.
You recognize he is the healer? Yes. You know what he really told me to lay hands on the sick? You know he really was talking to sinner. But when Jesus sent out the disciples, when you hear when he spoke to them, he'd be talking to them to go out there and preach to them. God will live, I mean, he will heal you through the laying of on hands. But his perfect will is you get to his word and believe what he said. Hallelujah. And I don't want to take for granted that everyone here is saved and don't cry. You hear a testimony through one that the sister that has spoken this morning, what God done for her.
Yes.
And you heard other testimony, what Brother Rico said that God done for him.
Mm-hmm.
You know the same God will do it for you.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So if you want me to touch you, agree with you, pray with you, mm-hmm. I'll be willing to do it. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. If not, praise God, we'll turn over the path to Him and we can go on home. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Lord, we just thank you for your people. We thank you for everyone that is here, the ear that are here. Father God, we thank you that they receive. In the name of Jesus, we thank you that the word would transform their life, Father God. Hallelujah. Your word is medicine to our flesh.
Yes,
we thank you for the law of life in Christ. You made us free from the law of sin and death.
Yes.
We thank you that all that you accomplished and what you have went through in our behalf through the cross, just for us, that we might reign in this life, that we might reign over sickness, that we might reign over death.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Jesus. In this life.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. We thank you, Father God. But we are the righteous of God in Christ Jesus. We are right standing before Him.
Yes.
We thank you that the ear of the Lord is open to the cry of the right deliverer.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And we thank you, Father God. We give you the praise and the glory.
Jesus.
As we cry out to you, Lord.
Jesus.
Lord, help us.
Lord.
And the other cry that we have, Lord, we have the cry of victory.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. That we have won the victory over the enemy. We thank you, Father God. We give you the praise and the glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Glory to God. By the way, that was another cry. You just can't read it. That get in your head was a cry of victory.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you can cry now.
Yes.
And you can cry later.
Yes.
So that you want that last cry of victory. Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Have a wonderful, wonderful message. We'll have a word from God. Is everybody on your feet? Let's just praise God for our deliverance, our release. Christ had. Text somebody just said, Christ had delivered us from the power of darkness. Satan's power over my life was broken over 2,000 years ago. Satan is defeated. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. The spirit of the law of life in Christ Jesus makes us free. Hallelujah. How many believe you are free? How many will turn around and tell somebody else? Amen. I am free. Christ has redeemed me from the curse of the law. I'm not trying to be free. He the Son says free shall be what? Free and free indeed. Hallelujah. How many believe that God's word is right now? It's true right now. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. If he healed 2,000 years ago, he is the same God that still healeth thee. Lift your hands and praise God for him. If you have been delivered, if you have been healed, if you have been touched by the power of God, you can say for sure, hallelujah, that Christ has redeemed me. He has delivered me. He has redeemed me. Hallelujah. By his stripes, I was healed, not trying to get healed. Amen. Let's just praise God for what he has already done. Amen. By praising God for what he has already done, hallelujah, he will make it manifest in the now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. To turn around and tell three persons I'm free. Satan's power over me was broken. Yeah, 2,000 years ago, and I'm going to act on my rights. Yes, Satan's power over my life ended. Hallelujah. Over 2,000 years ago, I'm recognizing that I am free. I am healed. I'm blessed. Amen. Lift your hands and praise God for what he has done for you. Tell him as loud as you can, then we can go as loud as you can. Lord, tell God, thank you for setting me free. Thank you for setting me free. Come on, Sakala. Thank you for setting me free. Come on, Amahoda Maha. If you want to walk in the reality of it, Tamasata, Lord, thank you for setting me free. He said if we delight ourselves in him, he will give us the desires of our heart. I'm going to shout. I'm the oldest one in here, I think. Hallelujah. I'm going to shout. Hallelujah. I'm free.
I am healed, I'm blessed.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.